الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده على من لا نبي بعده ولا أمة بعد أمته ولا كتاب بعد كتابه ولا شريعة بعد شريعته أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن مثل عيسى عند الله كمثل آدم خلقه من تراب ثم قال له كن فيكون وقال تعالى أيضا لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله ثالث ثلاثة وما من إله إلا إله واحد صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, in our program Rays of Light, we look at different themes from the Holy Quran. In the last two nights, we have been speaking about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, his family, his mother, the miraculous birth, and what he said at the time of his birth. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, as we know, there are this aspects amongst humanity that people have different aspects with regard to his miraculous birth. There are those, Aliyadu Billah, may Allah Ta'ala protect us, that they do not even believe in the miraculous birth. So if they do not believe in the miraculous birth, what they believe naturally as a consequence of that is the illegitimate birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. May Allah Ta'ala protect us. But there is a group of people, and there is a religious group that believe in that. And there are others who look at the miraculous birth and attribute divinity to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah so beautifully tells us, Inna mathala Isa inda Allahi ka mathali Adam. The example of Isa alayhi salam is like the example of Adam. Allah Ta'ala created Adam alayhi salatu wasalam without the agency of both a male and female. And Allah Ta'ala created Hazrat Hawa without the agency of a female. Allah Ta'ala created Isa alayhi salatu wasalam without the agency and the means of a male. This is part of the Qudrat of Allah which he has. The Sunnat of Allah is that normally by the meeting of male and female, well, a child and life come into being. But Allah Ta'ala has a Qudrat to go against that, as has been displayed and as has been given examples of. Now Allah Ta'ala, with regard to that view of those who hold that because of the miraculous birth, Allah Ta'ala has refuted those who say that he is divine. And Allah Ta'ala has in various ways in the Holy Quran refuted this view. In the sixth supara we find that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has refuted it in three different occasions. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةً لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. That they have committed kufr who says Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is one of the Trinity. The Trinity, according to some, becomes a whole and it represents Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says they have committed disbelief who say Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is divine and he is Allah. Now Allah ta'ala refutes it by saying, firstly, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam himself told unto the Bani Israel, U'budullaha rabbi wa rabbakum, worship only Allah who is my Lord and who is your Lord. So the person whom you are claiming to be divine and claiming to be Allah, he himself has refuted it. He told unto his people that no, worship my Lord and your Lord who is Allah. And وقال المسيح يا بني إسرائيل عبدوا الله إنه ما يشرك بالله. He who associates partners to Allah, even if he associates me as a partner to Allah, then فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة. Then heaven becomes forbidden for such a person, because he has reduced Allah to the level of a human being by saying that Allah has children. تكاد السماوات يتفطرن منه وتنشق الأرض وتخر الجبال حدا أن دعوا للرحمن ولدا. So the last page of Surah Maryam, Allah Ta'ala says it is enough for the earth to split. It is enough for the heavens to fall down. It is enough for the mountains to be destroyed. That humanity have attributed a son to Allah, that is against the power and the qudrat and the majesty and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is impossible for that to happen. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the sixth supara then refutes the divinity in such a beautiful way. Mal Masih ibn Maryam illa Rasul. Masih ibn Maryam is a messenger, the way there are messengers like Ibrahim and Musa and Isa and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his mother, Siddiqah, she is truthful and she is someone who is full of modesty. And how can they be divine? Kana ya'kulan at-ta'am. They both used to eat food. When someone is dependent upon food for existence, how can they be divine? How can they be Allah? Subhanallah, what a beautiful. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, according to us, a very great prophet of Almighty Allah. The ulama have mentioned, and from the Quran, there are similarities between Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Isa alayhi salam will come as part of this ummah. So Al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam saved the first portion of the ummah and was with the first portion of the ummah. Isa alayhi salam will be with the latter portion and the last portion of the ummah. Then both Isa alayhi salam and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam grew up without fatherly love. Allah ta'ala looked after them and made their tarbiyah. And you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cared for them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nurtured them. Right? Then both of them were given a book, Atani al-Kitab. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the Quran, Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam was given the Injil. Then fourthly, Allah ta'ala says, وَأَيَّدَنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ. Both of them, the fourth point of similarities, both of them were held by Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam. So, وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ بِالْحَقِّ. Both of them were given, held by Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam. No Nabi between the two. No Prophet between the two. Both raised to the heaven from Jerusalem, from Masjid Aqsa. Subhanallah. Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam raised to come back as one of the signs of Qiyamah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised at the time of Mi'raj. The predominant quality of both the Prophets was mercy. And both of them will be buried in Madinah Munawwara. Subhanallah. These are some of the similarities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then denies the aspect that Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam was put on the cross. Allah ta'ala says, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا سَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّ عَلَوْمُ. He was not killed. He was not crucified. The people had been completely, they had a misunderstanding with regard to it. He was not killed. Allah ta'ala says, إِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى إِنِّي مُتَوَفِّيكَ وَرَافِيُكَ إِلَيَّ. Allah ta'ala says, O Isa, we will lift you up towards ourselves. And miraculously, he was taken up by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards the heavens, and he will reappear. And Allah ta'ala says, وَإِمْ مِنْ أَحْلِ الْكِتَابِ. Even the people of the book, إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِ. They will believe in him as Islam had said, that he is a messenger of Allah before Isa alayhi salatu wasalam's death. And lastly, we will make mention with regard to it, that on the day of Qiyamah, seventh supara of the Holy Quran, Surah An'am, Allah will ask Isa ibn Maryam, Ya Isa ibn Maryam, أَعَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَٰهَيْنِ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. O Isa, did you tell the Bani Israel and your people that they should regard you and your mother as lords besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Isa alayhi salam, as Allah tells us in the Quran, Surah Ma'idah, the seventh supara of the Holy Quran, Allah ta'ala says, he will tell unto his people, Subhanak, ma aqulu an aqula ma laysa li bihaq. Oh Allah, how can I tell people except that which I have the right to say? You did not give me the right to tell them to worship me. Ma qultu lahum. I only told them what you had commanded me. An i'budu Allah rabbi wa rabbakum. That they should worship one Allah, my Lord, your Lord. In these three programs, we had looked at what some aspect of what the Quran had said about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. It is absolutely beautiful, the miraculous birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the honorable mention of his family, how his mother was, how Allah ta'ala praises the mother, how Allah ta'ala praises him, how Allah ta'ala refutes the divinity, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he himself, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, refuted this aspect that he was divine, how Allah ta'ala raised him up towards the heaven and he will return as a ummati of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah give us a tawfiq of coming closer to the Anbiya alayhi wa sallam and be inspired by their message. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
الله.